So now let's see how to integrate 1 over 2 plus cos x. And this is something that we definitely should use the Weierstrass substitution. If you want to multiply the top and bottom by 2 minus cos x, and it unfortunately won't work. Anyways, this is how it goes with all these ingredients right here. This is the same as integral of 1 on the top over 2 plus. For cos x, we are going to change into this. 1 minus t squared over 1 plus t squared. And then for the dx, we have all that. 2 over 1 plus t squared dt. And you see, we can take this integral into the t world right away, huh? Within one step, with all these ingredients. And now let's do some clean up. So, this is the integral. On the top, we have 1 times 2, which is just a 2 on the top, over. And this part right here, it technically has the parentheses, and it will multiply with this part, 1 plus t squared, right? So I'm going to take this and then multiply with the 2. And we have to distribute all. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times t squared is plus 2t squared, right? And then we add it with, we take this, multiply with this part, 1 plus t squared and 1 plus t squared will cancel each other out. So we just have the 1 minus t squared, and this is it for the denominator. And we have the dt right here. And of course, on the bottom, we can combine the terms. So altogether, this is integral 2 on the top over 2 plus 1, which is 3, and then 2t squared minus t squared, we have positive t squared, right? So we have plus t squared dt. And now, is this something that we can integrate? Sure, but this is something that we have to do first. Let's take the 2 out, so we have the 2 in the front. And then, I don't know how to integrate 3 plus t squared in the denominator. I know how to integrate if we have 1 plus something squared in the denominator, right? So let me also factor out the 3, okay? So I'm going to write this as 2 over 3, integral 1 over, I factor 3 out from the denominator, so this will become a 1 right here. And then we have a plus. Originally, this is t squared, but then we factored out the 3, so what should we have? Well, this is going to be t squared over 3, like this, okay? Dt. Real quick, if you distribute the 3, 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times t squared over 3, we get back to the original denominator like this, right? So this is legit. And now I have to do a few more things right here. I'm going to look at this as t over something and then square, but then let me write down the rest first. This is 2 over 3 integral 1 over 1 plus. This is going to be, I want to write down something inside and then square. What should I put down? Well, t right here. No problem. But then originally this is the 3. I want to put this in the parentheses and then square. So I should have over square root of 3, right? Square root of 3 square give us this 3 right here. And the purpose of this is that we can now use u sub, let u is equal to t over square root of 3. And then you see du will be pretty much a derivative. This is just 1 over square root of 3 dt, right? And then you can multiply both sides by square root of 3. So dt is equal to square root of 3 du. And then this is equal to 2 over 3 integral 1 over 1 plus. Inside is the u, and then we have that square. And then the dt is this, square root of 3 du. And what can we do next? Well, constant multiple, this should be out in the front. So we have 2. And then the square root of 3 over 3, and then the integral, let me just write it down again, integral of 1 over 1 plus u squared du. Can we integrate this? Yes. And in fact, you can use the formula right here as well, but then I think I want to show you guys all the steps to derive the square root of 3 here. Anyways, we can fix this number a little bit. 2 times square root of 3 over square root of 3. We can write this down as 2 over square root of 3. Why? Because this is 3 to the 1 half power. This is 3 to the 1 power in the bottom. 1 half power minus 1, you get negative 1 half, which is the same as square root in the denominator. Anyways, you can just do that. But then the integral of this is just the inverse tangent of u. we're done with the integration, and now we have to go back, and then we have to go back. So let's go back to the T world first. For U is theta, right? T over square root of 3. So we have 2 over square root of 3 inverse tangent of T over square root of 3, right? And then finally, we have 2 over square root of 3 inverse tangent. And let me write this down as 1 over square root of 3 first. And for the T, we know this is tangent of x over 2. So I'll put that down right here. The original tangent of x over 2. And then this right here will be the final answer. So I will put a plus C, and then we are done. Hope you guys enjoyed this question.